Oh, he is so much fun. He's such a good dog.
So we actually have
yeah.
Okay, yeah, sure.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, I'm sorry. He's working.
Oh, yeah. No, so is he.
No, he's,
he's totally working.
So, yeah. It says a train service dog.
Yeah, I know mine too.
Sorry. Yeah.
So that dog is, he's working right now.
So it would be okay.
That's what you said. So it's mine.
Yeah.
So if you would be okay with that, it's mine.
Could we arrange a crate? Did your dog poop on the floor when you came in?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Really? Are you sure?
My dog is a train service dog.
Yeah.
You can back him up, please.
Yeah.
I'm just going to ask you to step outside for a little bit because your dog is quite, he's barking quite a lot. And
he's
stuck on the floor. Well, if you just, if you scan these QR codes right here, then you'll just see, you know, the different rules that we have as Ryan's.
Oh, my goodness, that's so cute.
Here is the biggest one to protect people with service dogs. And patrons. I mean,
immediately, like full wrapping.
Do you want to be aggressive?
Yeah, maybe. We're trying to diffuse and inform here, right? But if you got two dogs, and you feel like you need to get around here and see what the heck's going on, by all means.
Okay.
Yeah. Just don't position yourself in a place that will hurt you.
Okay.
Give yourself distance. Don't pet the dogs. I don't care what the person says. Don't ever pet a dog in this establishment. Just don't. Because if you do, then everyone else will. Even if the person says, no, it's true, it's okay. It's not okay. Because you're serving food. And they're the customer coming in to receive food. And other people will see that too. So even if you went and washed your hands and handled it. A lot of people offer my dog water. I always turn it down. Unless I really need it, like 96 degrees and I need to come prepared. I turn it down. No, I have a service dog. I'm equipped. I mean, I carry with me all the time. And if I don't take care of his needs, he can't take care of mine. So I don't need, water for my dog. But thank you. I appreciate it. That's not helpful. And if you go out, like, to the Valley of Law, different culture, their policy will look totally different. Like, a patio, your policy is pretty ironclad. So your communication and your interaction with that person. Most people with a trained service dog want you to treat them just like a person and ignore the dog. You wouldn't walk up and say, what a fine wheelchair that is. May I touch it? Oh, that's awkward. Yeah. This is the same thing. I know it's a dog, but he's fuzzy and he's cute and he's got a heart, but yeah, it's the same. When he's working, he's working.
So, when we ask them, because we've had people bring like their puppies in before, and they just think they're the greatest thing in the world.
Right.
We're
not pets.
Right, yes.
You don't have to not think it's the precious thing in the world.
Yeah.
You have a policy.
Yeah,
and it's not
thrown food. But
yes.
My question is they're obviously thinking it's great, but if we said, we'll take the drink and then we would be more than happy to bring it outside to
yes.
them, and they're
yes.
like, oh, that's all right. I'll just sit over here out of the way.
Yeah, you go into it. We have a policy.
Okay.
So then you kind of have to be a little bit more.
Okay.
But people will take your suggestion.
And then we ask,
okay, social cue, we really want puppies here.
Right.
You go. If they don't, then you go to the next step. They don't go to the next step. You're handing the puppy and walking. You can actually put them in the comfort and walk them up there. Like demonstrate. Like, hey, yeah, come on this way. We're walking. And you took the order, so whoever was in the store dealt with the puppy as you take the order. Hopefully nothing happens there.
Yeah.
And then, how should you go?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're just going through the process.
And
you don't want to escalate it, but you want to repeat each step. Just repeat and repeat and repeat. And
I guess my question is like, I really feel like in the moment, the questions are probably going to go out of my head.
That's why it's there. It lives there.
Right. You know, so it's going to stay there on the counter? So
yes, that lives there. Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So then they come up and they say, now just sit out of the way. Then they say, well, we have a policy. What, no dogs in the store?
We have a no pets policy.
No pets policy.
Sorry, that's a lot.
No
by law, you can even say.
Okay.
Okay, by law, we only allow service dogs.
Okay.
Trained service dogs. Well, this is a puppy even trained,
Yeah.
But some people will push it. Some people don't know. Remember, you guys are more informed than the person on this side of the counter, 9 times out of 10.
Okay.
So they don't know. So you're coming to them with a approach of curiosity. Is that a service dog?
Okay.
Yep. 4-month-old puppy? Can't be.
Okay, yeah.
Can't be. Okay? Don't care what you're investing on. They say it has to be 4.5 months or older. So,
okay.
Can't be.
Okay.
I don't want to go into too much detail and clutter your brains with this. You've got a process.
Okay.
The thing is follow it through. Then when you see me, go, hey, had a situation, follow this through. Here's what happened. How do I improve it?
Okay.
I can improve the program that way. That's how it's come about.
Okay.
People just, they help me. I don't know what to do when I get there. You have a tool, just calmly go through the tool. It doesn't even matter the outcome right now. You know what I'm saying? Like, no one's saying, well, you're going to get fired because you can ask that question.
Yeah.
And their own thing there.
Yeah.
You guys know what YN stands for. Yes, I know you know this. I come in and I feel it the minute I come in, whether I'm a dog or not. So I know you know that. Embrace that culture in this program. Make this yours. Don't do what I'm telling you. Make it yours. That's all you have to do. Just ask the question. If you don't do anything else but ask the question, and if it goes by on a conveyor belt, and you go, crap, I should have done it this way, okay, next time it's better. Just ask the question. Asking it is organic intervention. Just by asking, people are going to hesitate before they bring that dog in. pretty small. He'll say, yeah, why is this a new program? I'm nasty. I don't know what to ask. I'm not going in there. So you have to be more comfortable with asking than they are of receiving the question.
Okay.
If they're comfortable receiving it, then you're going to get that response, oh, I haven't had it here before. You know? Okay. But we just went into training. Just so you know, I'm not sure you're aware. That's a great one to use. I'm not sure you're aware, but okay. I'd love to share this with you. Okay, so this training, here's what the training was about. We adopted this policy. We put a stranger on access. You know, just tell them what it is.
Okay.
And then here's your flyer if you want to know.
Okay.
I did have a question. There is a customer that comes in and she has like a smaller dog and she holds it. I'm assuming the rules don't change just because they're holding the dog, right?
Dog in the building is
okay.
Yeah.
Only it's. Yes, you can do. Probably not a transference dog. There's not a hard rule, but there is an understood sort of a culture rule in our work, that the dog should be 4 feet off.
Okay.
Wheelchair, a little bit different. Might be on that. But you get the idea. Yeah, I know you're not going to address that.
Yeah.
But 4 feet on the floor, should be the first.
Mm-hmm.
They get away with it. They do it at Walmart, they do it everywhere else. You know, and I'm not saying they're going to fix and change the world, guys. People are still going to do what they do, they're not going to change anything. We're just going to ask a question. Just have the courage to ask a question. That's what this is. Do that, we're successful. Not, I don't want you to rub somebody wrong. I don't want you to, you know, how they respond is not in your control. How you ask the question and follow the process is in your control.
And you just ease through it one step at a time. You did a great job with that. You did a great job.
Really, I mean, very tough. Yeah, the hardest scenario, and you took it back because I don't know if the team was like, here, shove her up front, here, you do it. You know, I don't know. Sometimes like, I would go to Grounds for Pleasure and I would already, I like walk in and then nobody wants to look at me. And I'm like, okay, anyone gonna serve me at all? I don't want that either. So I'm like, then what? Then I go out and I come back in and someone's appointed at that. You do it for her. Okay? I don't care. It's like, you do it. And so I walk off and ask a question, and I'm kind to them as kind as I can be. Thank you for asking. I mean, that's not what everybody's going to do. You see somebody with a great dog coat on, what you're going to do? They're going to say thank you for asking. Because we know that asking is the first step of transformation. We know that, one way or another. We know that we will have teams that can go into the public and be safe. We know that we have informed partners on the other side of this counter. We know that. And that's what it's going to take. The laws aren't going to get us there, enforcement isn't going to get us there, this isn't going to get us there, information is powerful stuff. And that's all this is about. So the essence of it is really what I want to make sure that you understand. I'm not putting you on the spot saying you have to fix this problem that we have in our society. But I'm saying, hey, this thing exists, there's laws, and there's a gap, and we are that bridge. And we're just there, it's kind of a swinging bridge, and sometimes there's some slack missing, and I understand that, but we're just there. So, any questions on the gallery side? All right.